Personal expenditures jumped another 3.3% from a year ago.
Says total U.S. credit card debt just hit $1 trillion.
The White House, in partnership with the Federal Trade Commission and the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, has announced new efforts to crack down on tens of billions of dollars in junk fees. These hidden surprise charges that corporations sneak onto customer bills increase costs and stifle competition in industries across the economy. A new rule has been proposed which says that the late charges will be lowered from $30 to $8, saving customers up to $9 billion a year in late fees. This is a huge step to keep the companies in check who use these tactics to make you pay more in order to increase their profits. This takes a huge toll on family budgets, and the White House intervention is a massive step toward stopping it. But this doesn't come without consequences. The corporations are looking to stop their lending, which will disrupt the entire economy. We're experiencing a record surge in defaults, hitting the highest levels in 24 years. Presently, debt delinquencies are on the rise, surpassing 2019 levels. 43.5 million Americans have resumed paying their student loans in October. What can we expect in the coming months? A probable increase in deficits across various sectors. With the upcoming holiday season and increased spending on gifts, people will rely more on credit cards. This will lead to a higher rate of defaults. If the companies struggle to collect fares, they will identify high-risk individuals and their access. This trajectory will lead to what appears to be an impending credit crunch in the United States. The corporations generated around $130 billion in revenue from interest and charges in 2022. They mentioned that consumers carrying balances paid more compared to what they earned in rewards. Undoubtedly, these corporations aim to make profits, and it's understandable they won't provide more rewards than what they earn. Yes, the interest rates are undeniably high, and the assessment is agreeable. However, credit cards serve as an economic lifeline for many Americans. The current scenario is alarming, with defaults escalating. The 60-day delinquency rate for individuals with poor credit reached an all-time high of 6.1% in September, up from 5.8% in August, as reported by Fitch Ratings. This level of delinquency hasn't been seen since 1994. According to Federal Reserve data, 90-day delinquencies have increased to 5.1% from 3.4% in the second quarter of the previous year. This consistent rise in delinquencies for three straight quarters indicates increasing pressure on customers' ability to repay general card balances. Nearly half of Americans rely on credit cards to cover essential living expenses, a survey reveals. This necessity is more prevalent among younger generations, with 59% of millennials using them for living expenses, while 29% of boomers depend on them for such needs. The looming issue is the mounting debt that more Americans are facing due to rising interest rates. The discussion around the $1 trillion in credit card debt raises concerns. There's a push to regulate these cardholders. It's similar to payday lenders or installment loans, where higher interest rates are charged due to the inherent risk. They charge more to offset the risk associated with such loans, given the higher likelihood of defaults. As a result, American customers currently find themselves in an increasingly precarious financial position. Who would be willing to lend money to everyday Americans under these conditions, where they do not receive sufficient compensation for the risks involved? Not many would likely step forward. This is the concern the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau is addressing by proposing a 75% cut in late fees. The current focus of the White House and the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau involves implementing measures to protect customers from what's perceived as excessive charges. The recent proposal aims to regulate how businesses price their transactions and make fares more transparent. The Federal Trade Commission is considering a rule to ban businesses from imposing hidden or misleading charges, necessitating upfront disclosure of the total price. This rule would affect various industries, including ticket sales, hotels, rentals, and more. Non-compliance would result in penalties and refunds for customers. Additionally, the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau plans to mandate major banks and credit unions to furnish customers with the necessary fee-related information. For instance, eliminating fees for basic services, such as checking account balances. The rhetoric around these initiatives raises doubts and skepticism. This is because most banks don't charge for checking account balances through their online apps or at their branches. You're not charged a fee for obtaining information like a payoff amount on a loan or account details needed for applications. There's a question about whether the stated intentions align with broader motives, or if there's a more significant agenda at play behind the scenes. It's a matter that raises curiosity about the larger implications of these regulations. the Consumer Protection Bureau is set to propose a rule that, if approved, would mandate economic corporations to enable customers to securely share their banking transaction data with other banks and corporations. This move aims to make it simpler for individuals to switch to corporations offering better services, thus fostering competition based on quality and transparent pricing, reducing unnecessary charges. According to the Bureau, bounce checks have decreased by more than 86%, and almost two-thirds of major companies have eliminated these fares entirely. Studies conducted by the institution show that charges associated with bounce checks, which effectively cost up to $40 per transaction, disproportionately affect low-income and minority Americans. The findings suggest an annual reduction of $5.5 billion in banking-related fees. It is also set to issue $140 million in customer refunds to corporations charging illegal fees, such as surprise overdraft charges and multiple balance check fares. The entire banking and credit industry is expected to face significant scrutiny in the coming months as these initiatives ramp up. Additionally, Fitch Ratings notes that there's been an increase in delinquencies in loans, particularly in credit cards and auto loans. This rise in delinquencies, coupled with the depletion of savings, will lead to higher provisioning by larger regional banks. This action will impact bank reserves and profitability as they brace for a normalization in card balances and associated risks. There's a new regulatory framework on the horizon known as Basel III Endgame. It's a significant change where the government will impose stricter regulations. This will influence how banks hold deposits and lend money. It's a game changer set to roll out in about 12 months. They are currently preparing for this change by adjusting their standards regarding how they hold deposits and to whom they lend money. Recently, regulators extended its proposal's comment period to January 2024, causing uncertainty about how these rules will affect the industry. Economic institutions like JP Morgan, Bank of America, and Citi are projecting an increase in risk-weighted assets, estimating percentages that range from 16 to 30%. Banks will cope with the higher capital requirements, but will reduce their lending, leading to lower loan growth in the near future. In light of these upcoming changes, getting a loan will become harder. Institutions will prefer lending to individuals with higher credit scores, a longer history of making timely payments, and who seem more likely to repay without issues. As a result, borrowers with lower credit scores, like those in the subprime range, will find it harder to obtain loans. The current average credit score among 205 million Americans stands at 698, but this figure will drop significantly over the next 6 months due to various economic factors such as student loan situations and broader economic turmoil. Ultimately, this change in regulatory standards will restrict lending to individuals with lower credit scores, impacting a large segment of the population and leading to challenges in accessing economic resources. It's unlikely that we'll see an increase in its usage and issuance moving forward. Instead, there seems to be a growing problem for many Americans in obtaining access to it. The continuous ramping up of regulations presents challenges. Companies will have to reassess the situation and potentially reevaluate whether lending is worth the associated risks. With the ongoing rise in defaults and the push for reduced late payment fees, they will have to rethink their entire business model. If they can't generate income from charges, they will focus more on the interest accrued from lending money. This will significantly alter how they operate. If you heavily rely on credit cards in your daily life, these changes will definitely impact how you access and use loans. The evolving landscape will result in stricter standards and reduced availability of credit for many customers. In 2023, the real estate market in the United States went through some changes. There was a slight drop in home sales and median sale prices in specific periods, and it's important to highlight that the chance of a housing market crash is very high. Even though certain areas experienced price decreases, the limited number of homes for sale compared to the demand has kept prices relatively high. Experts foresee a substantial overall decline in home prices this year. The real estate market will not start to recover until late 2024 and 2025. The situation in Minnesota saw a huge decrease in median sale prices and a significant drop in the number of homes sold. There has been a decrease in available homes to buy, and it has made it more unaffordable for buyers. Plus, attractive tax policies have drawn more people away from buying houses. In 2023, the appearance of strong credit card spending in the United States is masking potential trouble ahead. Despite hitting a record high in debt, there's an unsettling increase in overdue balances, almost at pre-pandemic levels. hinting at looming financial distress. The rise in delinquency rates is a concerning red flag, suggesting a shaky economic future. A looming credit crunch threatens to bring on dire consequences. It's expected to prompt reduced consumer spending as people become more cautious with their money. The escalating delinquency rates further burden individuals struggling to meet their payments, painting a worrying picture. Financial adjustments by issuers aimed at stabilizing vulnerable groups like Gen Zers and households with children highlight the fragility of our economic system. The looming risk of forced home sales due to global shocks will push families into chaos, potentially resulting in home loss, a catastrophic outcome in an already precarious situation. Issuers facing reduced revenues will cut costs by altering rewards value, which would negatively impact the users and further unsettle an already fragile economic scenario. Although initially showing a slight increase, the slowing growth in spending signals an economy losing its vigor. Despite some optimism and economic buffers, middle-income customers will find themselves struggling amid stronger economic headwinds. The supposed positive outlook for consumer spending in the United States is overshadowed by the looming storm of reduced spending, higher delinquency rates, altered credit card offerings, increased risk of forced home sales, and potential rewards devaluation. The seemingly optimistic economic landscape is a ticking time bomb. The signs of an impending credit crunch pose a significant threat to customer behavior, financial stability, and the wider economy. If left unchecked, these vulnerabilities would lead to a severe economic downturn. Comment down below on what you think. And if you like this video, please consider liking, subscribing, and sharing the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.